Have you ever wondered exactly how deep in space is Deep Space Nine? Or really how far away is Alpha Centauri on an interstellar scale? And where was the contact from Contact? This video will show the location of where these stories take place relative to the solar system with real-life star position data. Nerds like me have a sort of obsession with maps. I don't know why. And I am aware that stellar cartography can be
pretty dry stuff.
So I made this moist. I made it as pretty and as interesting as I could. For example, did you know that there's a connection between the Greys and the Xenomorphs? So if you want to see where these stories take place in the galaxy, stick around. This is the Milky Way galaxy. It is a disk about 100,000 light years across and 1,000 light years thick. Earth and the solar system are located here, about 28,000 light years from the core. Star Trek's USS Voyager was propelled to around here, 70,000 light years away in the Delta Quadrant. And Deep Space Nine is positioned at one end of a wormhole that goes from around here to here in the Gamma Quadrant. From this distance, it's not possible to differentiate between Sol and DS9. So let's zoom in to a 350 light year bubble and start with the closest star and move outward to DS9. In this 350 light year bubble, there are more than 25,000 stars and dozens of sci-fi references. So we're only going to visit a select few because ain't nobody got time for that. Alpha Centauri is the closest star system to Sol, and it's actually not one star but three. And the closest one, Proxima Centauri, is only 4.25 light years away. Which is far, yes, but it's so very close in the scale of the galaxy. So close that it has captured the imagination and has been the subject of countless numbers of sci-fi stories. Here is an incomplete list. Also some impressive failures. It was the destination of the Robinson family from Lost in Space before they got lost in space. It was also the destination of the ship from the 1997 movie Event Horizon before the experimental gravity drive took it through literal hell and back without ever getting to Proxima. Bummer. But a more relevant reference from within the last decade is that it is the location of Pandora from Avatar. The lore of Avatar is surprisingly scientifically plausible. They use unobtainium, a room temperature superconductor, as a way to contain antimatter in their antimatter reactors on their interstellar ships, which are called ISVs, which stands for Interstellar Vehicle. This, in combination with a laser-beamed light sail, allow them to reach 70% of the speed of light and get to Alpha Centauri in only 6 years. Which is all scientifically plausible. What they do when they get there is also plausible. The second closest star to Sol is Bernard's Star, another red dwarf that is just under 6 light years away, and is featured in the Roche World series by Robert L. Ford, which has an awesome hard sci-fi laser light sail concept, where the main sail splits apart and reflects back onto it to slow it down. It's awesome and I want to do a video on it. The third closest star to Sol is Wolf 359, a red dwarf 7.7 light years away, which is of course the location of the infamous battle with the Borg from Star Trek The Next Generation.
Starfleet reports it has engaged the Borg at Wolf 359, sir.
Epsilon Eridani is 10.5 light years away. It is the location of the Babylon 5 space station. And just a stone's throw further is 40 Eridani, 16 light years from Sol. It is the home star to planet Vulcan, until it wasn't. 40 Eridani and Tau Ceti are also the setting for another hard sci-fi, Project Hail Mary by Andy Weir, author of The Martian. If you like The Martian, I highly recommend reading it. No spoilers, but there is an inspiring implication from Project Hail Mary. And that is that the distances in our universe are vast, but even with the speed limit of light, it's not physically impossible to reach them. It's just a very hard engineering problem. And at some point, even if we don't invent some kind of space-bending, physics-breaking, faster-than-light drive, it's still scientifically plausible to reach the stars in a human lifetime. And that's just inspiring to me. Link in the description. Speaking of inspiring movies, the next stop is the star from the 1997 movie Contact, Vega.
We put it right smack in the middle. Vega.
Which is 25 light years away. In the movie, the signal comes from Vega, but it is just a relay station. When she travels through the machine, it opens a wormhole that takes her there as a first stop in an intergalactic transit system that end up taking her all the way to the center of the galaxy. The book by Carl Sagan, which the movie was based on, goes into way more detail on this, and again, I also highly recommend giving it a read. Next up is another one of the most famous star systems, even if you don't know it by name. Zeta Reticuli. 39 light years away, it is home to the xenomorph from the Alien franchise. Most of the Alien franchise takes place in this system on the moon of LV-246 and various other moons and planets. Also here in real life, Zeta Reticuli is purportedly where the Greys come from in UFO lore. Bob Lazar claims he was told the flying saucers came from here, and the star map from the Betty and Barney Hill story purportedly point to here. Also, the alleged Project Serpo references Zeta Reticuli. And that's all I have to say about that. I just wonder if the Greys and the Xenomorphs get along. And our last stop before we get back to Star Trek is Dune. Caladan and Gaedi Prime, the homeworlds of House Atreides and House Harkonnen, respectively, are located in the real star systems of Delta Pavonis and 36 Alpha Eukai. Both are just under 20 light years from Sol. And Arrakis, also known as Dune, is 310 light years away, all the way over here in the Canopus system. And finally, we're back to Deep Space Nine, which does not have a real-life named star system and is only referenced as being near the fictional system of Bajor. There isn't really an official map of Star Trek. The closest we can get to canon was this 2002 book of Star Trek star charts. When using it as a reference, puts DS9 here, about 62 light years from Sol. But it's a two-dimensional map, so we don't know exactly where it is. This, of course, was not a comprehensive list. Let me know in the comments what I missed, and if you like this, like it, and subscribe if you want to see more science and space animations. Thanks for watching.